This is going to be a quick video that will provide you with an easy way to remember the carpal bones. It's using a simple mnemonic. The mnemonic I like to use is so long to pinky, here comes the thumb. There's a lot of mnemonics out there, but I think this is a good one because it helps you with the orientation and the anatomy as well. So this is how it works. If you take a look at the x-ray image of the right hand, you're going to label the 8 carpal bones as shown here. You're going to start with the proximal row and count 1 through 4, beginning at the thumb and ending at the pinky. You can use the mnemonic to help you remember the orientation. The last word in the first line of the mnemonic is pinky, and this will help you remember that you're going to end with the pinky in that proximal row. Then you're going to move to the distal row, counting 5 through 8, beginning at the pinky and ending at the thumb. You're going to use the mnemonic again to help you with the orientation. So going to the second line of the mnemonic, the last word is thumb, and this will help you remember that the distal row will end at the thumb. So now let's walk through this mnemonic. So long to pinky, here comes the thumb. This will help you remember that the proximal row is scaphoid, lunate, triquetrum, pisiform, and that the distal row is hamate, capitate, trapezoid, and trapezium. Now the other factor that commonly trips up people is that there's 3 carpal bones that start with T, so it's tough to remember which T goes where. Well, I've got another simple trick with this, and it's the following. Starting with trapezium, you're going to remember that it rhymes with thumb, so trapezium is near the thumb. The mnemonic makes this easy because it uses the word thumb, and that will help you remember that trapezium is in that 8th position. But also, if we look at that x-ray, you can see that the carpal bone that's next to the thumb is carpal bone number 8, and this will be the trapezium. Moving on to the trapezoid, this sits next to the capitate. And the way to remember this is that trap and cap rhyme. So as you use the mnemonic and you get to capitate, you'll remember that trapezoid is next because they sit next to each other and trap and cap rhyme. Lastly, we move on to triquetrum. So if you use the mnemonic above, the triquetrum actually sits in the 3rd position. So take the tri and triquetrum, and this will help you remember that it's the 3rd carpal bone.